This contest, scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from Louisville, Kentucky, weighing 225 pounds, Billy Travis. And his opponent, from San Diego, California, weighing 271 pounds, Jesse the Body Ventura.
Well, sir, there is a look at the Body. Jesse the Body Ventura, that is, and Mr. Ventura extremely proud of what he feels to be, Gene Okerlund, the most extraordinary physique in professional wrestling today. Would you concur with that?
Well, I would have to certainly agree with you on that, and that attire and that hair, certainly extraordinary, to say the least, Vince McMahon.
Mr. Ventura feels that he does have indeed the most extraordinary physique. You do agree with Mr. Ventura then?
That he, he doesn't have the most extraordinary physique. The man has got good size, there's no doubt about that.
Look at that hair, Gene. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a designer hairdo, according to Jesse the Body Ventura, as Mr. Ventura rids himself of all kind of jewelry and whatever dangling from his ears. He had about 5 pounds of it there on the right ear.
And he takes his time about it also. Those sunglasses.
I wonder if they're diamond studded. See all the jewels around the glasses? All right now, Jesse the Body Ventura. Just about ready to lock up with Billy Travis.
Oh, look at him nurse that hair.
I would suspect that might be one thing Mr. Travis would do right away. Grab a handful of that multicolored hair. Ventura with tremendous arms and shoulder development. 270 some odd pounds of him, and Travis locks up. Wants a test of strength right away of the Body, and the Body snaps him down to the canvas. So right now, oh, there's a look.
Oh, look at him bulk up. Loves to pose.
Well, you don't get a Body like that out of a box of Cracker Jacks. You have to wear a nice full Nelson by Billy Travis. And we'll see now if Ventura can put that physique to work now. Oh. Trying to press it, breaks it. Nicely done.
And with tremendous authority, no doubt about that.
We have not seen a great deal of finesse and scientific skill thus far displayed by Mr. Ventura, for that matter, nor by his opponent, Billy Travis, as he locked back up. And now Ventura asserting himself. Ventura on the receiving end now. Billy Travis working on the wrist.
And Ventura quite obviously doesn't like it a bit. You can see that expression on his face. Oh.
Ventura now with Travis and knocked him flat to the canvas. When you're 270 plus pounds, as Ventura is, you can really slap somebody down to the canvas in a hurry, and there, the slam down to the canvas. Off the rope now, the leg dropped across the head. Ventura with things pretty much well.
Yeah. Oh, come on. Really?
Oh, down in the midsection, Travis connects again. Travis with an uppercut. Billy Travis with another one, and Jesse Ventura backing off a bit as Travis moves in. It's Ventura for the ride. Coming in and running into a knee to the midsection. You could tell that Billy Travis was hesitating just a bit, and you just can't do that with a man like Ventura.
Absolutely not. You cannot be tentative. You've got to follow through. The fluidity has got to be there. Oh, chop.
Wow. Devastating. Ventura now with pretty much complete control. An uppercut, open hand, I believe it was, but nonetheless to the throat area.
Well, quite obviously to the throat for good measure. Jesse throws in a couple of knees to the midsection of the back.
Referee finally backs off the Body as we heard him.
Uh-oh. Oh, no.
Well, Travis almost landed on his feet outside. Perhaps he was not hurt severely.
Well, from our vantage point, of course, we cannot see. We don't know for sure. Well, there we do see a shot of Billy Travis trying to gather his thoughts and put himself back together. That, by the way, should be pointed out, hard concrete floor.
Billy Travis, though, spun around by the body who dropped the big forearm.
Well, Vince McMahon, I'm sure you would have to agree, Jesse, the body Ventura, like him or not, has certainly made his presence known to the World Wrestling Federation.
Indeed he has, and likely to continue making his presence known. The referee having some difficulty in maintaining order here. Look at the smile on the face of the body. He just thinks he's gorgeous.
He certainly has got all of the self-confidence a person would need. Not admitted in the least.
Travis over the top rope and pulls up another body on top of him now. Spins him around and Ventura drops a knee into the facial area of Billy Travis. To the roof. Forearm into the back of Travis. To the rope again and another shot, and the body continues to work on the back area of Billy Travis. Bends him over and gets him all the way up.
No.
Jesse, the body Ventura with the backbreaker, and Billy Travis wastes no time in submission. A very painful hold. And there, finally, Jesse, the body Ventura, releasing the hold. And you hear the round of boos by the fans about ringside, most of whom are not in appreciation of the talents and tactics of one Jesse Ventura.
The winner of this bout, Jesse the Body Ventura.
And as the body gives us another pose yet, displaying his physique, let's go back now to what we saw moments ago. Now here, Ventura delivering the backbreaker. Up goes Billy Travis, Mr. Travis. And a tough uphill battle, really, all the way through this matchup. Unfortunately for Mr. Travis, not at least in this match, at this particular time, of the same caliber as his opponent, Jesse Ventura. And look at that. Look at him.
Oh, you know, it was tough for me during the course of the match to really concentrate on it. That hair serves as a source of distraction. Flamboyant, gregarious, and a lot more.
Jesse the Body Ventura victorious.
Short your tickets in advance. Wild Samoans to go against Tiger Chung Lee and Mr. Fuji. And the tandem of Bob Backlund, former world champion, and B. Bryant Blair. What a team they are to meet tag team champions Adrian Adonis from the Big Apple and his partner out of Waxahachie, Texas, the pride and joy of that fair city. I'm talking about Dick Murdoch.
You know, when I was going to college, you know, as a history major, and they kind of try to breed into us in Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, right?
Oh, it is indeed.
It is a city of nothing. It is a happening, nothing happening town full of a bunch of nothing happening melon farmers.
Melon.
Now, let's get one thing
melon?
Straight. Melon farmers, a bunch of nothing happening Yankees. Now, let's get one thing straight. You know, we're going against a legend, a professional wrestler, probably a man that is in the greatest physical condition of anybody in this profession today, in Bob Backlund.
I have
another capable wrestler,
Brian Blair.
I know Brian Blair. I know Brian Blair. He went to the University of Louisville, probably the lowest academic standard college in America. Now, let's get something straight, but they are definitely going against
now. You've been talking with Tom Brookshire.
Did you ask me to come out here?
Yes, I did.
All right. Cool your jets in, Red Eye. Now, you're going against right now the world's tag team champions of Adonis and Murdoch, the North-South connection. That took a lot for us to get together. But Adrian Adonis knew that we had a great tag team combination. So did I. So he moved to the land of fruits and nuts, to California, and we got it together. And I'll guarantee you what, Philadelphia, everybody's heard of the Spectrum. Everybody's heard of the Spectrum. And that where that low-class basketball team of theirs plays or anything else, where there's no athletes of Philadelphia at all. They've never had a winner. The Eagles have never had a winner. They got an old washed-up quarterback in Jaworski. They fired the greatest coach ever had in Dick Vermeil. And now they're going to see the greatest tag team combination in the world today in Adonis and Murdoch. And also, from the bottom and top of that card, the greatest wrestlers in the world today, the WWF Federation.
You know, you knew more about Philadelphia than I thought you did.
That's where that little bell runs around. It's got a crack in it. Everybody knows that. Hey, we can't fool a Texan, me and Gene. We are the greatest and proudest people in the world today. And in Philadelphia,
that's quite obvious. That is quite obvious. I thank you, Dick Murdoch. We're going to be right back.